Everybody. First of all, I must thank the organizers for organizing this conference and then inviting me to be part of it. I think it's a wonderful idea to have a conference at this level where we can talk freely about the problems and possible solutions. I hope by end of the day we will have a few solutions to the problem which we are facing. And for this, I'll make a very short presentation. You know, when Pakistan was created in 1947, how does it go forward? There were less than 100 doctors in Pakistan and less than 6 specialists. That was the way we started in 1947 healthcare in Pakistan. But since then, perhaps this is familiar to some of you. This is Patiala block in King Edward Medical College. And it still is known as Patiala block because this was built with the donation of Maharaja Patiala. This was the block of King Edward Medical College when Britishers established 5 colleges in India. One was in Calcutta, Chennai, Lucknow, Mumbai, and this was 5th one. So this was the only college we had in 1947. And so this is mother institution, but since then we have more than 100 medical colleges now. And one thing special, which perhaps India doesn't have, that is College of Physicians and Surgeons of Pakistan, as Sayyid Yaver Ali mentioned this morning. This is the body which certifies and oversees training of all the specialists in Pakistan. So it's a centralized body since 1962. Whereas in India, every university gives MD and MS. Recently, you have introduced central board, but previous that board doesn't oversee the training part. They only certifies, examines and certifies the specialists. But our College of Physician Surgeons, it oversees training and certifies as well. And you can see a large number of trainees have been registered with that, 18,000 in Pakistan and outside Pakistan as well. You know, this college, when it certifies its fellows, they are having examination boards in Nepal, Saudi Arab, and other Middle Eastern countries because the standards which we have laid down of training and evaluation, they are acceptable to all these countries. And so we have trainees in overseas as well. And healthcare structure in Pakistan is similar as it has been mentioned. But I spent some time on this because in this morning session and in this session, one thing in which I feel we can share and we should collaborate with each other is medical education. Because medical education required for our region is similar, and as the number of doctors required in India and Pakistan, they are so large that our students are going to China, Russia, and other countries for their education. Whereas we should be sharing them. Medical education in India is much more expensive than Pakistan. And unfortunately, we don't get Indian students coming to Pakistan or Pakistani students coming over here. This is at undergraduate level. And as far as postgraduate or specialist level, I would like to see more interaction between institutions. When we say collaboration, we just don't define what collaboration is. I would say that there should be institutional contacts with each other so that there's direct speech. They speak and they organize the training and also care of the patients. And then perhaps something concrete will come out, and with positively this organization can project in next meeting. This is how we have made the progress. Well, there are few specialties where we are not lacking behind. Not necessarily it should be one-way traffic for liver transplant coming to India. You could avail our facilities as well in Pakistan, say ART, assisted reproductive techniques or treatment of infertility. It was mentioned a lot of patients come to India for infertility. Mind you, these are those patients, whereas in Pakistan, we don't allow donor egg, donor sperm, and surrogacy. This is not allowed in Pakistan. So those kind of patients come over here. But for routine infertility treatment, we have similar standards as in India and similar facilities. So similarly, in other health cares, so suggestions for, there should be more collaboration, no doubt about it. As I said, it should be one-to-one, not a generalized kind of thing. But the second part is the awareness. Mind you, most of the Pakistani population is not aware of facilities in India. That's why they're still going to China. Those who can afford, they're still going to America, England. And as it was mentioned by Neil, the transplant results in their hospital, Medanta, are as good, perhaps better than most of the centers. So this kind of awareness is not there. We have to create awareness in the public and also amongst the professionals who guide the patients where to go. So for this, all the national and international conferences which are held, this organization should make sure that somebody goes and speaks in those conferences across and create awareness that these are the facilities which are available in both countries and they should be shared like that. And of course, difficulties have been mentioned. Visa has been mentioned so many times. I just want to narrate a story. A friend of mine, gynecologist, who lives in Bombay, is a big name in gynecology. As a matter of fact, these days, he's president of FIGO, that's world body. And he invited me to attend his daughter's wedding. Sent me a card, I applied for visa. They asked my credentials, that my income tax, and utility bills, and ownership of the house, things. I kept sending those papers. But at the end of it, they asked me to provide all this of my host. His utility bills, his ownership of the house, and you can imagine how embarrassing it could be that asking him, send me your telephone bill, tell me your electricity bill. So I called him, I said, yaar, tum chahte ho main aaun, to phir ye bhi zarurat hai. Then, because he is in Bombay, he is a big gynecologist, he spoke to somebody, only then I could get a visa. So these are kind of, I don't know how to reach embassies on both sides. It's not one side. It's a sort of balanced act. And we should, I have no idea how this body or this group can influence or facilitate visa, but the problem is real. But this was about the pharmaceutical, just I thought I'll put up this graph. The population in Pakistan is growing so fast, unfortunately. The need for pharmaceutical industry is going to grow even faster. So if the two sides collaborate in pharmaceuticals, as Sheila has mentioned, the difficulty. So we could make good use of it. And this is the world trade challenges. Well, I would say, in addition to the visa and everything, collaboration in medical education and research, that's most important. because our difficulties, our problems, our diseases are similar, and we don't collaborate, and very little literature comes out of these two countries, whereas others are, and Pakistan particularly is lagging behind. So you could make use of our data and come out with greater results or better results to show this. Well, this was like Mother Teresa saying for us, Edhi. He recently died. He made this statement, no religion is higher than humanity. So today we are talking about healthcare, about humanity. So in this, there should be no borders, no religion, no biases, only patient care or health care, which we want to improve or push and do better. To achieve this, well, we all wish this, but we don't know how to get it. But it should be there. And last of all, the aim of argument of our discussion should not be victory, but progress. I think this should be conveyed to all the politicians, all the leaders. This is how we can collaborate and move forward. Thank you.
Rashid Latif Khan gave you a brief overview of the physicians and surgeons structure also in Pakistan and the health structure in Pakistan. And also he mentioned about collaboration with India in medical education. I think this is extremely important that there has to be a student exchange program between India and Pakistan seeking education across both countries. And I think that's a wonderful idea. But the more importantly, he mentioned about the institutional linkages between the two countries. And of course, sometimes when we choose words, we're not very clear about what we really mean about collaboration. So collaboration can be a vague term, but if you look at it more concretely, it can be nothing can substitute for institutional collaboration. Also some of the areas as Pakistan specializes in, the Indian health sector can benefit from, for example, in bone marrow transplant and also in ophthalmology and cancer. And he also made some suggestions about medical examinations and also the awareness gap between the public and the professionals on in particularly about the health sector and more generally. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to open the floor for question and answer sessions. So we have a half an hour, and I would like to give the audience a chance to ask questions from the panelists. And when you ask questions, please briefly introduce yourself, keep the question short, and also by identifying the name of the panelist whom you are addressing to. So the floor is open now. Sir, your question, please.
Thank you, Chair. My name is Yogesh Kumar, I'm a former ambassador. I have one of the questions to ask the panelists. One question is that Ms. Mansoor, Rabia Mansoor, she mentioned about the difficulties in import of surgical equipment by India. Is it possible for her to identify, as regard this particular item, what are the difficulties that are actually experienced by exporters from Pakistan to India? And the other question I have is for Mr. Durrani and also the others who made the same point. You talked about the lack of possibility of importing pharmaceuticals from India to Pakistan because of the price structure that you have. We also heard the statement in the morning that the consumption cost of health care in Pakistan is, I think, about three times higher than India. How did they reconcile with this the statement that the consumption cost of medical, let's say, medical consumption cost, so to say, is higher in Pakistan, not in India? And if the prices are kept low under the price control system of Pakistan, how, I mean, what are the prospects that you have in terms of innovation, in terms of developing new products, and even widening the range of pharmaceuticals that Pakistan actually has the capacity to produce? Is it because of Pakistan's pharmaceutical industry has some concerns that, you know, like some other sectors have about being flooded by Indian products? And at the same time, we have heard that there are far more greater volume of products being actually taken, routed via the Dubai route. So obviously there is some imbalance somewhere in that. And I have actually, maybe I can make one or two suggestions too. The issue of medical visa, I have an idea. I served in Islamabad in our mission for 3 years in the early 90s. If, for example, let us say the government were to appoint a qualified doctor from here, government doctor in the mission in Islamabad and Lahore, for example, who could certify that the patient applying for medical visa actually is an emergency case requiring immediate treatment? In which case, perhaps under discretionary powers of the head of mission, the person could get the visa, and then, of course, whatever formalities the Ministry of Home Affairs may have, they may carry them out, you know, subsequently. And one, just two broad comments, if I may. I think we'd realize that India-Pakistan relationship is quite accident-prone. So we have to keep that in mind. Whatever progress we've made, there's always a slide back, as actually is happening even today, for example. What are the difficulties in actually exploiting the telemedicine, that kind of a link between the two countries, exploiting them more and using them for professional conferences, for example, where you participate based on that? And what about the SAARC framework? Because if you approach via the SAARC framework, perhaps this bilateral thing, which actually becomes problematic at times, that particular aspect can be taken care in many respects. And just one last point. You know, I find a lot of TV channels in India, for example, they have the sponsored programs about, doctors and so on and so forth. I'm just wondering, a lot of TV channels are received in Pakistan as well, and they're quite popular. So I'm wondering whether, let us say, this particular joint forum can take a specific initiative to actually have the sponsored or features in, let's say, in Urdu, so that people can follow widely and they understand what the facilities are. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, please go ahead.
Gautam Vora. The positive news from the speakers in from Pakistan was the high quality of medical equipment and also the very competitive rates in which you produce generic medicines. The other areas, for instance, in which India goes ahead is in research.
Sorry for interruption, sir. Could you please mention your question to the panelist?
Well, let me. I don't want to identify. This is a general question. What I basically want to know is that there are a lot of areas where this collaboration has been spelled out, and for instance, Dr. Raj Raina talked about knowledge transfer, training, telemedicine was pointed out, then medical education. Now, until the political relationship improves, is it not possible, and this is to doctors on either side, for private medical institutions in Pakistan, establishing a relationship with the private medical institutions, say Apollo, Vedanta, etc., and having that direct links, because a political relationship is flawed. And it will remain a problematic situation. But is it possible, and there are doctors present here who had links with private to private. You have 50 private medical hospitals now, as per your latest record. So that is the issue that I want to raise. Because there's so much area of collaboration. Nothing can happen unless we break away from the government-to-government contact.
Right. Questions from this side? Would you like to ask? Yeah, please.
Thank you very much, Shariar. My name is Professor Javed Akram, and I'm the Vice Chancellor of a medical university called Shahid Zulfikar Ali Bhutto Medical University. And I am the CEO of PIMS, which is Pakistan Institute of Medical Sciences in Islamabad. Very enlightening discussion, wonderful presentations and follow-up. But I was just wondering since morning that what are we going to achieve from all this? What are the tangible goals? And I don't see this going ahead, unfortunately, because we do not have really any goals that we are going to achieve in the next 1 year, 5 year, or 10 year. We are largely dependent upon the political situation. We are largely depending upon the conflicts between the two countries. And they are beyond the scope of this August House. However, when we talk of trade in health sector between India and Pakistan, trade has to be two-way. We have been talking about trade from India to Pakistan, but not much from Pakistan to India. So we'll have to explore those avenues to make it a sustainable trade, because only then the stakeholders from the both sides will be interested. I think some gentleman just there raised a question about SAARC. That's a very good idea. And in fact, Pakistan is hosting SAARC convention this year. And this was my idea to my prime minister, and it has been approved, that on the sidelines we are going to have SAARC Medicus, that within the SAARC we are going to have a medical group working. And the rationale for that is that our genetic profile is very similar. We have very similar medical issues and very similar solutions we have. We have to, when we talk of India, we are potentially talking of the largest, most populous country in the world after 25 years now. And when we talk of Pakistan, we are talking of third largest population in the world in year 2032. Because we happen to be producing more children than anybody else. So we will be, and when we talk of Pakistan, India together, since we are Indo-Asians, we have very similar risk factor profiling, very similar genetic background, very similar disease prevalence. But when both these countries, they rely on the data from the West, because there is hardly any collaborative research between us two. So we have to have that platform of the medical people working together. And it's a very good opportunity. We are hosting this SAARC convention this year. And on the sidelines, my university is going to be hosting the SAARC Medicus. This is the first time that SAARC Medicus will be launched. And this is the purpose of this. And the chair will lie with my university for the next 5 years. So obviously, it is going to rotate amongst the. And that will also help us overcome the lingering problem of the visa. Because if you have SAARC visa, you can cross, like I carry SAARC visa. I crossed the border and just came here in about 1.5 hours or 2 hours. And similarly, the SAARC can facilitate these visas to Indians, to Pakistanis, because you don't need to be city-specific. You don't need to have a route-specific. You can do whatever you want with it. And this visa is multiple entry for 1 year at least, or maybe 5 years. So, you know, there is a light at the end of the tunnel, but we just need to explore that. And we just need to be focused that what are our achievable goals. And I think that is very, very important. Similarly, we do have a lot of other forums, like I represent Royal College of Physicians as international medical advisor. And also, I represent American College of Cardiology as regent for Southeast Asia. So we can explore those bodies, bring in them. But the problem is that we are just talking of marketing some products on both sides. We have to go beyond that. We have to have collaborative boards. We have to have collaborative research. We have to have university-to-university linkages. We have to have industry-academia partnerships. And only then it will become tangible. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I would like to give a chance to the panelists to answer the questions, and then we can have another round of questions.
OK. Okay, regarding the question of the difficulties of the export in the surgical products, and there are too many difficulties in the export of surgical products to India, but the main problem is not the facilitation of the direct export of the surgical products to the India. In this way, because the cost will be high, and the second reason is the political conflict, and there is no the institutional collaboration between the surgical industries. Maybe these are the reasons that the export, India is not importing the surgical products as much higher level to the Pakistan.
Is there a ban on that? Is there a ban on imports?
No, there is not a ban. But the volume of the trade is very low in the surgical products. Yeah.
एक्स एम्बेसडर साहब ने अभी क्वेश्चन ये किया है कि जी इंडियन फार्मूलेटेड ड्रग्स मैन्युफैक्चर्ड ड्रग्स इन पाकिस्तान, उस हवाले से मैं ये कहूँगा कि नो डाउट आपको यहाँ पे बनाना, अपने पास रॉ मटेरियल मैन्युफैक्चर करना, यहाँ गुड्स जो है ना मैन्युफैक्चर करना, जाहिर है कि आप, हम तो आपसे रॉ मटेरियल मंगवाते हैं ना, और मंगवा के वहाँ पाकिस्तान में मैन्युफैक्चर करते हैं, आपकी ड्रग्स की कॉस्ट ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इज नो डाउट लो, बट द रियलिटी इज दैट द प्रोसीजर ऑफ ड्रग रजिस्ट्रेशन बाय ड्रग रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी ऑफ पाकिस्तान इज क्वाइट कम्बरसम. देर आर सम एप्रीहेंशंस रिगार्डिंग द चीपर प्राइसेस ऑफ ड्रग्स इन India as compared to Pakistan, but the whole situation is not like that. We have almost 10-15% drugs cheaper than India as far as generic to generic comparison is there. अब यहाँ पे एक बात और मैं अर्ज करूँगा कि इस सिचुएशन को यूज़ करने के लिए चाइना भी पाकिस्तान के अंदर फार्मूलेटेड ड्रग्स को मार्केट करने के लिए आया और वापस चला गया. ठीक है, वी आर इन पाकिस्तान मार्केट ओरिएंटेड फार्मास्यूटिकल रिजीम. आप मेडिसिन यहाँ से भेज देंगे, उसको मार्केट करने के लिए आपको एक पूरा फ्रेमवर्क चाहिए. रजिस्ट्रेशन हो गई, उसके बाद मार्केटिंग का आस्पेक्ट आ जाता है. इसी तरह बांग्लादेश ने भी एक दो दफ़ा कोशिश की है. मैं इस आपको डिस्करेज नहीं कर रहा इस इशू पे. बात यह है कि अभी मेरे भाई जावेद साहब ने अभी बात की है, प्रोफेसर साहब ने बड़ी ज़बरदस्त बात की है कि वी आर टॉकिंग ओनली अबाउट द इम्पोर्ट फ्रॉम इंडिया टू पाकिस्तान. दैट शुड नॉट बी देयर. विन विन सिचुएशन कांट prevail on this way of talk. अब बात यह है कि मेरी कुलीग जो हैं राबिया, इन्होंने बात की है कि सर्जिकल गुड्स जो हैं, सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, वो पूरी दुनिया में पाकिस्तानी सर्जिकल जो इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हैं वो एक्सपोर्ट होते हैं, और हमारी एक्सपोर्ट का ऑलमोस्ट, इफ़ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, राशिद साहब शायद इसको करेंगे, मोर देन 30% आवर सेगमेंट ऑफ टोटल एक्सपोर्ट इज बेसिकली फ्रॉम सर्जिकल गुड्स इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. ठीक, अब यहाँ पे ये आ जाता है कि आपके इंडिया में ये वाला शोबा थोड़ा सा नेसेंट है, और देर इज़ नो क्वालिटेटिव एज ऑफ इंडिया ओवर पाकिस्तान ऑन दिस सेक्टर. अगर आप थोड़ा सा ना, क्योंकि इसके अंदर थोड़ा से नॉन टैरिफ बैरियर्स भी हैं. ठीक है, अब बात यह है कि अगर आप पाकिस्तान को एक्सपोर्ट करना चाहते हैं फार्मास्यूटिकल ड्रग्स, और उसको फार्मास्यूटिकल ड्रग्स को एक्सपोर्ट ही नहीं करना, आपने उसकी मार्केटिंग भी करनी है. मेरे साथी बैठे हैं कि व्हाट इज़ डिफ़िकल्ट टू मार्केट अ जेनेरिक और ब्रांड प्रोडक्ट एंड टू एस्टेब्लिश दैट. अच्छा, अब दूसरी सिचुएशन में यह है कि जब आप पाकिस्तान से सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स इंपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, तो देर इज़ नो नीड ऑफ एनी एक्सटेंसिव मार्केटिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ सेगमेंट. तो इसमें यह है कि अगर आपको पाकिस्तान से सर्जिकल गुड्स सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट आप मंगवाते हैं, तो जो आप यूरोपियन सोर्स से मंगवा रहे हैं, चाइनीज मे बी पॉसिबल चाइनीज सोर्स से भी आप मंगवाते हों या और जितने भी सोर्सेज हैं, उससे आपकी जो है वो फॉरेन एक्सचेंज के अंदर कमी आएगी, आपको फ़ायदा होगा। तो जहाँ तक बात है कि अगर इंडियन फार्मास्यूटिकल जो मैन्युफैक्चर्ड ड्रग्स पाकिस्तान में फिनिश फॉर्म में आप लाना चाहते हैं, उस सिलसिले में मैंने आपको ये बता दिया है कि चाइना आज से 30 साल पहले हमारी 50% मार्केट जो थी ना उसको कैटर करता था, वो आहिस्ता आहिस्ता श्रिंक हो गई। अब चाइना अच्छा, अब लास्टली मैं जो बात करना चाह रहा हूँ ना वो ये करना चाह रहा हूँ आपके क्वेश्चन के अंदर कि ये आपके मीडिया में भी बात आती है और हमारे मीडिया में तो ये समय ले कि पॉलिटिशियंस की ये बात फार्मा इंडस्ट्री को डराने के लिए, नहीं जी हम चाइना से इंडिया से दवाइयाँ मंगवा लेंगे आप सही हो जाएं, अपने आप को ठीक कर लें, क्यों जी हाँ सब ऐसे ही है ना, आप ठीक हो जाएं, नहीं तो हम चाइना से मंगवा रहे हैं, भाई मंगवा के देख लें आप, ठीक है जब इंडिया से मंगवा के देख लें आप। तो फार्मा इंडस्ट्री को का गला दबाया हुआ है हमारी गवर्नमेंट ने सिर्फ इस ग्राउंड्स पे, क्यों जी खान साहब, कि इसी ग्राउंड पे कि जी नहीं हम इंडिया से मंगवा लेंगे आप ठीक हो जाओ, और 2003 से हमारी कोई प्राइस इंक्रीज नहीं है। तो ये मैं आपको ये बता रहा हूँ कि इस सिचुएशन के अंदर ना हमें एक्चुअली परसेप्शंस को ठीक रखना है कि पॉसिबिलिटीज, देखिए एक चीज़ आप सोच रहे हैं कि जी हम ये कर लें, अब करने के लिए जो ग्राउंड रियलिटीज़ है ना उसको देखना बहुत ज़रूरी है और उसकी इम्पेडिमेंट्स को इरेडिकेट करना बहुत ज़रूरी है। बहुत शुक्रिया।
जो प्राइस परसेप्शन है वो अच्छा। हम सर्वाइव कर रहे हैं, हम किए हैं, हमने सर्वाइव फॉर 15 इयर्स विदाउट अ प्राइस इंक्रीज, ये ऐसा ही है ना
जी जी,
और 15 इयर्स में कोई इंपोर्टर आके इसे इंडिया का वो सर्वाइव ही नहीं कर सकता, फॉर 15 इयर्स देयर इज नो प्राइस इंक्रीज, स्टैटिक प्राइस, एंड देन देयर इज नो एसेंशियल ड्रग लिस्ट, सारी की सारी प्राइस प्रोडक्ट्स आर अंडर प्राइस कंट्रोल इंडिया में, इट्स अ हेवन, सिर्फ 330 आर अंडर प्राइस कंट्रोल, बाकी सब फ्री है। सो आप
Yes.
No, they're only 330. बाकी तो नहीं है ना?
He's suggesting that the other cheaper drug should be exported.
नहीं तो हमारे को तो है ही नहीं ना, लिस्ट इन लिस्ट में नहीं है ना, मीन encouraging नहीं है ना both ways.
I'm saying Pakistan can export drugs to India.
Yeah, yeah, but the thing is the same thing prevails here, the registration. ये तो नहीं है कि इधर आसान है. The same thing happens there or there, the same thing. There will be registration takes years. बाकी countries में अगर हम जाएँ तो it takes 2 years. यहाँ पर इंडिया में तो टेक्स्ट लाइक 10 ईयर्स टू गेट अ प्रोडक्ट रजिस्टर, तब तक उसकी लाइफ ही खत्म हो जाती है। अगर आप आज अप्लाई करेंगे पाकिस्तान तो आपको भी इतने साल ही लगेंगे, बट यू गेट द रजिस्ट्रेशन द प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल इन द मार्केट, तो वो आप क्या करेंगे?
एंड वन सिंपल क्वेरी ऑन कंटिन्यूएशन विद बोथ द एक्सपर्ट्स हू आर स्पीकिंग नाउ, व्हेन यू गेट अ जेनेरिक ड्रग हाउ डू यू चेक द यू नो the validity or whatever the correctness of that, how do you go about that? So I was in somebody's talk, I heard that there were issues with that lab. Was it you?
No.
Yes, you said that you have to send for the lab, you don't have a single lab.
No, that lab is wo jo lab hai jisko hum BAVE kehte hain, bioequivalence and bioavailability lab, that is validation uski check karti hai na product,
correct,
that is only once.
No.
The routine checking is by the lab, the DRE labs. Once the validity is established, फिर
आप मुझे allow करें।
जी जी।
कि यहाँ एक और बात बड़ी ज़रूरी है। When you are exporting finished drugs to any country, there is requirement of registration of drug. When you are exporting raw material to any particular country, there is no need of any sort of रजिस्ट्रेशन। अब पाकिस्तान के अंदर जब जो आपका रॉ मटेरियल आ रहा है उस रॉ मटेरियल की रजिस्ट्रेशन रिक्वायर्ड नहीं है, इसी वजह से क्वांटम ऑफ एक्सपोर्ट फ्रॉम इंडिया टू पाकिस्तान रॉ मटेरियल इज ड्रास्टिकली इंक्रीजिंग। इट वाज प्रीवियसली ये जो केयर टेकर हमारे पीएम आए थे ना मिराज खालिद राज साहब, उनकी ये बहुत बड़ी एफर्ट्स थी, ठीक है ना, देर वॉज नॉट अ सिंगल इंग्रीडियंट यू कुड इम्पोर्ट फ्राम इंडिया। तो कुछ लोग फार्मा के लोग उनके पास गए, उन्होंने कहा जनाब एक हमारे ऊपर मेहरबानी कर दें कि हम चाइना से मंगवाते हैं
वो 7000 किलोमीटर का फासला तय करके शिप आता है 3 महीने के बाद। और जनाब यहाँ पे कई दफ़ा जो है ना वो हमारी असेंशियल ड्रग्स अवेलेबल नहीं होती। हॉस्पिटल ने ऑर्डर दिया है और पता लगा जनाब शिप चलेगा उसके बाद पहुँचेगा। उन्होंने जनाब इसको बड़े अच्छे तरीके से सुना, ये बात शायद 80-90 की बात है शायद, और ये बहुत बड़ी ब्लेसिंग फार्मा इंडस्ट्री पे हुई है कि हम इंडिया से फार्मास्यूटिकल रॉ मटेरियल इंपोर्ट करने के काबिल हो गए। अब ये देखिए,
सॉरी फॉर द इंटरप्शन बिकॉज आई नीड टू टेक अनदर राउंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस। सो आई वुड लाइक टू गिव अ चांस टू हसन साहब, बशीर साहब टू ब्रीफली रिप्लाई टू द क्वेश्चंस एंड देन आई वुड लाइक टू हैव अदर साइड।
इसमें एक एंगल जो डिस्कशन में नहीं आ सका वो परसेप्शंस का थोड़ा सा जिक्र जरूर हुआ। मार्केटिंग के हवाले से फार्मास्यूटिकल प्रोडक्ट्स के एक परसेप्शन जो आवाम है उसकी भी काउंट करती है और जो प्रिस्क्राइबर्स हैं उसकी परसेप्शन भी काउंट करती है। सो दैट परसेप्शन हैज़ टू बी डेवलप्ड एज फार एज इंडियन प्रोडक्ट्स आर कंसर्न। एंड जहाँ तक चाइनीज़ प्रोडक्ट्स के नाकाम होने की बात है वो भी एक बहुत बड़ी वजह यही है। और वो जो मैंने आपसे पहले भी कहा कि वो प्रॉब्ली हम जेनेरिक्स के साथ इतनी जल्दी नहीं डेवलप कर सकेंगे, रादर रिसर्च प्रोडक्ट्स या वो प्रोडक्ट्स जो कि ब्रेक थ्रू प्रोडक्ट्स हैं इंडिया के अंदर और पाकिस्तान में अवेलेबल नहीं है या बहुत महंगी प्राइस पे मल्टीनेशनल्स के बैनर्स के नीचे अवेलेबल हैं, उनको मार्केट करने की अगर आप कोशिश करेंगे तो आई थिंक कि वी माइट हैव अ चांस।
क्वेश्चंस प्लीज, प्लीज गो अहेड, काइंडली इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ एंड।
माय नेम इज मोहम्मद अब्दी, आई एम फ्रॉम सोमालिया एम्बेसी, द कमर्शियल अथॉरिटी। My thanks goes to the organizers of the conference, and it's of my pleasure to attend. I have a suggestion rather than a question. And my suggestion is that there are a number of third world countries that are seeking health service to both countries, Pakistan as well as India. These people encounters several challenges on their way to come to India and to Pakistan for their health. Mostly, the service they are seeking is the transplanting, HIV/AIDS treatment of cancer, and so on. Those that they cannot get performance in their countries. And the challenges that they meet, the first one and the most difficult one, which is a very simple in a way, but difficult to them is the getting visa. Both embassies, if I take an example to my country, Somalia, both embassies are located in Nairobi. And the one who is going to get a visa has to go to Nairobi. To go to Nairobi, you have to have a visa. To apply to visa of India, it takes time. And to apply a visa to go to Nairobi is another issue. So the person, when he was in the hospitals of Somalia, it may take longer for his treatment that they were trying. And later on they say, oh, we can't, can you look for another, the nearest and the simplest and the cheapest to us is both countries. Now, if someone is getting visa for 3 months or 4 months, do you think how it will deteriorate his health status? Getting visa, another issue, getting visa is the first challenge that they are seeking. The other issue is the healthy cost and the living standard of the country they are coming to compared to their country. These poor populations who are seeking the service to your countries needs consideration. And that consideration needs establishment of a research. Now we know all the way of the research done. Now in all this to enhance this health trade. If possible, if there is now the world is small, internet is working, everything is working. If there is a linkage that the process can take through internet that they can apply and that they can get the visa while they are there. And
thank
you.
Get the permission. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir, for your wonderful suggestions. But I would like to give, if you have a specific questions, please ask. But okay. Suggestions, I can invite later on.
That is my suggestion.
Right,
thank
okay.
You very much.
Farid Saab, you want to ask a question?
Thank you very much. My name is Farid, Farid Alam, and I'm from the Asia Foundation Pakistan office. Thank you for organizing this wonderful conference. I have a very general question, and I think, you know, any of the panelists can address that. If I see, you know, from all your discussion and from your presentation, there is a big niche, you know, for growth in pharma and in surgical and institutional collaboration, as one of the participant rightly said, you know, like there are private institutions who can collaborate. But when I heard, you know, Mr. Yaver Ali's presentation, and I also know from, you know, from the background, the Pakistan-India Joint Business Forum, and there are all task forces, you know, as Yaver Ali sub mentioned, there are 6 task forces. But why there is no, you know, specific task force for this important sector, you know, because there are, you know, the people are facing issues. We have a big niche for the growth. So my question is, you know, is there is a low level, I think there is a low level of awareness at the private sector level. And I think there is a low level of awareness among the general public. And you know, between, you know, among the state, between the Pakistani state and the Indian state, you know, there might be some good interest, but you know, the state to state collaboration is also lacking. So we need to have a joint business forum, you know, like a task force for this important sector. So, you know, that's a general question, and I think any panelist can address that.
So who would like to answer this question?
I think that's what the agenda is that we're doing, and actually I was pretty impressed with Javed Saab's comments. And initially that frustration is always there, that what am I doing? Is it really going to be worth it? Or when you walk out of this room, it's all going to go in the drain. But all that I can say is Mount Everest was not climbed in a day. You need to take the first step, and step after step that you do it. So I wish Javedji was in the room. Unfortunately, I have some comments to be made for him, but he's going to miss it. So these type of meetings and the efforts that has been taken by the CREAR and SDPI has to be appreciated, because the warmth that is going, and there are a lot of ideas which each one of us are getting. And these ideas cannot go waste. There is going to be, and I wanted to put forward to him that on behalf from the Indian side, and since I've been collaborating earlier with CII, so I would probably take their permission or the CREA, and definitely try to collaborate with one of these two agencies. And if he has suggestions for the SAARC thing, what we could do is that in the SAARC, I mean, I would just be instrumental in ensuring that all the different branches, like it was cardiology, gastroenterology, the transplant, the medicine part, or the different branches, the associations which we have across on both the sides. So these associations from the country can decide and designate few people who can participate, and then those people can. So that could be. Because if we just keep sitting thinking, ki, what can I do? It's only the government or the politics do. But what is government? It's we who make the government. And the drive has to come from all of us, because if that enthusiasm is not there in us, we would not let it happen. Because we, the mass, are more in number. And gradually, if we realize that, both of us realize that it is a very small sector, which she rightly said is a small but strong. So we are big but weak. And these meetings make us realize that there's so much across. And I would also like to put it to Sami Ullah Khan and Javed Ji, that there was, it's like everything is a win-win. In the shorter term, you might feel that the other person is winning. But in the longer run, you missed a lot of my, Javed Ji, you missed a lot of my talk. I wish you could. We'll use the tape to say it, but in the long run, the person who seems to be weaker actually learns and wins more. At least that's my personal experience. Whenever I meet experts, I think I know less, but eventually you learn more. And there is equal sides to win, because the surgical instruments, he's made it crystal clear. If 30% of your exports are surgical instrument, the task force has to ensure that when there is a collaboration between the health agencies, their agencies has to put forward for the surgical instrument. This agency can put forward for the medical trade. And then when there is collaboration between the institutes, as both of them, and look at their expertise, Rashid Latif Khan and Javed Akram, their gray hair are speaking quite a lot, that they have the vision to see that it's not just people on this table, but it's the institutions which are going to make a difference. And who took us to these institutions? It was this forum who gave us these experts to take us forward. So I'm pretty optimistic. The glass is not half empty, the glass is half full. And kudos to, once again, ICRIAR and SDPI for this endeavor.
And I'd like to add one more thing. We have to convert, I think, all our endeavors into what's called as smart objectives. We have to be specific, we have to be measurable, that's what you were asking about, I guess. Then we have to be, our objectives have to be achievable, and then realistic, and obviously time-bounded. If agar hum ye apni tamam cheezein teen cheezon ke andar le aaye to wo jaise sabhi baat kar rahe the tangibility ki, I think then it starts coming out. And one thing, last but not the least, as the Americans say, that you scratch my back and I scratch yours, I think that has to be done as well.
Absolutely.
You want to ask a question? Please go ahead.
Okay. I think an excellent forum. Thanks to ICRIAR and SDPI. I'm Vivek Sehgal from the PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and I look after the health committee, which is the health sector. This actually question is directed to you. And this is about the research part of it. We've been talking about medical device. We haven't really talked about medical devices, and devices we probably focused, it seems, only on the surgical devices. Is there a broader study on medical devices which is going to be conducted, or is it a part of this? Because again, we have in the ultimate healthcare delivery system, medical devices playing a very important role, starting from a syringe to a catheter or many other things, where India has a lot of capabilities even in exports to European countries with CE norms. So I didn't hear much about that. So if you can enlighten me on it.
Right. One last question. You want to answer this? Do you want? Right, okay. Go ahead, please. You want to ask a question?
Respect to DICE, my name is Vidhi Garg, and I'm an intern at ICRIAR right now. So we have been talking a lot about pharmaceutical trades and the global competitiveness of Pakistan in medical equipment and surgical sector. But one thing that I'm not able to make out is what exactly is holding back the exports in this sector worth more than $300 million to India. I mean, what is it that Pakistan is exporting to all over the world but not to India? Why is it so?
Right, okay. Thank you. Nisha, you wanted to answer the question of the gentleman.
I wanted to make a clarification to Mr. Durrani, that when I talked about informal trade, what I was talking about was that a lot of pharmaceuticals are actually going through Dubai and entering the Indian market. And because it is informal trade, there is no quality control. There is no quality check. So it is the Indian drugs which are of suspect because they are going through an informal channel. But if they were going formally, then at least the quality check would be there, and the authorities can actually ensure that only good quality drugs come in. Secondly, I think on surgical instruments, and Vivek, you also very rightly said, we have in our study actually identified potential at the six-digit level in every category, like what is the quantum of import that is possible. And what we've done is we've actually looked at those items in which Pakistan is globally competitive. So we are not even saying that simply that there is a trade potential, but where they are globally competitive. And so why should we not be importing from Pakistan if Pakistan is globally competitive in those items? But the other issue of because there is lack of information between the two countries and the lack of platforms in the two countries, it's not perfect information. And so the markets are actually working in a vacuum. So there is still need to actually do an in-depth study into why is it that the imports are not happening. There could be non-tariff barriers. So that's why we have suggested mutual recognition agreements. That is one way of ensuring that the trade can happen. But if there is something beyond that, that needs to be found out. So right. When we okay. set up these task forces, these are issues that can be taken up.
Right. The lady asked a question. So
I think this explained her question as well. I think this explanation explains your question as well.
Are you satisfied with the reply of Professor Anisha? You asked about, you know, what is holding us back from raising our exports. That was your question. So some of the answers or questions relates to informational gaps as well as non-tariff barriers and as well as not having adequate research in areas which holds this trade back and obviously I think we need to look at the areas in competition and why we are not producing that export or imports regime. So I think if you look at my presentation again, it's a very complex situation. Your question is quite broad and specific and very important, but I think that there's not one specific answer which would satisfy what you have asked. So we have to look at this into a different forums. For example, there has been a mention of the SAARC. You know, what is the role of the SAARC? And how can SAARC facilitate the issues that we are discussing right now? I think it can play an instrumental role by having these task forces being institutionalized at the SAARC forum. And when you take this study forward based on the recommendations or the findings of the studies and then start talking about individual cases, for example, you've mentioned about the instruments. Somebody mentioned about the exports, somebody mentioned about the imports, the visa regimes and all that. So the task forces have a certain purpose to play, but I think that the SAARC is the kind of forum which can expedite these issues in more at the institution level, at the ministerial level. Do we have time, Nisha, for another question, or shall I just...
We have 10-15
minutes, so please. Yes.
Okay. My name is Naushad Ali Azad. I'm a professor of economics, teaching trade and doing some research in trade. Well, as a researcher...
A trade in health sector, basically.
Is a very, you know... small and part of overall trade between India and Pakistan. And we all are worried about the outcome of what is going to happen in future about all these discussions that we are doing about the trade. Well, we all know that much depends on the political will and the political environment that our countries have in future. We all are hopeful. I take the thread from what Neelam has been saying that basically in the two countries, a very large proportion of people, I mean this big majority, they want these things to happen, trade to happen, and trade in health sector also to happen, better relations, more visas, everything. But somehow a small but powerful thing is not let it happening. We can only hope for the better. But what I'm saying is that whatever we are doing, probably we can involve over this big, sector of the people by involving our youth participation, involving our, civil society, etc. I have two specific things, to mention that one to Mr. Shahryar Khan. Your institute, we can probably, we don't have a very competitive market existing between two countries. SAARC has been a non-starter and is not delivering for the goals that it was established to and things like that. This competitiveness and market, trade, better win-win situation, they come only if you have free market kind of thing, so better things will come, but we don't have the free market thing. But what we can probably at this juncture, hoping that we will have better relations in future in the interest of public good and public health, etc. Your institute can probably focus in delivering to the sustainable development goals. Many of them are related with health issues, education, and things like that. And not only in Pakistan, probably your institute can do some outreach for doing something in India. And our sustainable, development policy institutes can probably do same studies in the, so you can collaborate more on that. About this SAARC summit going to take place in Pakistan, and Mr. Vice Chancellor, your this college is going to host Medicus there. Probably we already have one SAARC University in New Delhi, where biotechnology is one of the courses being taught. Probably we can have the more exchange program there. You can probably insist having medical training, including undergraduate program, is started in this university, because this is financed by all SAARC countries, including Pakistan. Of course, India is the major contributor to this establishing university, but the students from all SAARC countries are studying there. We can start collaborating in medical education at this level. Thank you.
Yes, please. Kindly introduce yourself, please.
Hello, my name is Ashok. We import surgical instruments or equipment from Pakistan. There is no quality check. And when the same equipment or instruments are imported from Germany, which are probably routed through Pakistan, the quality is far better. Why is it so?
Okay. Thank you.
अब आप रेगुलर चैनल से थ्रू लेटर ऑफ क्रेडिट
यू आर इंपोर्टिंग थ्रू रेगुलर चैनल बाय ओपनिंग लेटर ऑफ क्रेडिट. ये बात हमें चाइना के बारे में भी सुनने में आती है कि पाकिस्तान में जो कुछ चाइना भेजता है क्वालिटी इज़ इन्फीरियर. अगर आप चाइना की चीज़ कनाडा, अमेरिका, किसी और मुल्क से, डेवलप कंट्री से परचेज़ करें तो वो शायद क्वालिटी में अच्छी होती है. अच्छा, अब इसकी क्वालिटी स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन की बात जहाँ तक है ना सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट की, तो उसके अंदर मुझे, चूँकि मैं आई एम नॉट टेक्निकल पर्सन, मैं फार्मा का बंदा हूँ, मेरे से आप कानून की बात पूछनी है तो बीइंग अ लॉ मैन मैं आपको बता दूँगा. पिछले 20 साल से मैं लॉ प्रैक्टिस भी करता हूँ. जी नहीं, इसका नहीं है सर. जैसे पाकिस्तान में ड्रग रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी ऑफ पाकिस्तान है, किसी जगह पे एक्सपोर्ट करते हैं हम फार्मा ड्रग्स, तो फिनिश फॉर्म में हम करते हैं या रॉ मटेरियल करते हैं, तो देर इज़ चेक. हाँ, अब इसके ऊपर कोई चेक नहीं है. देर इज़